I'm coming from Nova University of Lisbon in Portugal, and I'm also the coordinator of the UNESCO Chair on the Ocean's Cultural Heritage. As an academic partner of the UNESCO 2001 Convention on the Protection of the Underwater Cultural Heritage, we focus on researching, teaching, and disseminating knowledge about the precious human legacy located underwater and along the coasts of the ocean. I'm here to express the strong conviction that underwater cultural heritage is a public asset and not a private affair. As a representative of humanities, let me hence emphasize the crucial importance of history, because nobody can live without a memory. The oceans contain crucial evidence of our global past, and only knowledge of this past allows us to find a way to a sustainable future. From the experience we got in UNESCO meetings in Africa and Asia, as in an ongoing project we coordinate in Cape Verde, we know that underwater cultural heritage is perceived now by coastal populations in small island countries as a hope for the construction of a more accurate memory of their past, as well as an important asset for the creation of museums and touristic attractions, what means new and different tools for sustainable development. Therefore, in the name of historians and underwater archaeologists, I ask strongly that the protection of underwater cultural heritage shall be discussed in June in my city of Lisbon, in order to develop policies that integrate not only economic but also cultural aspects. We need to work together to avoid the pillage of our heritage by treasure hunters, reinforce identities, and develop a sustainable life for our communities, especially at the coast. Finally, please bear in mind that the safeguarding of our underwater cultural heritage goes hand in hand with the conservation of our natural heritage. We cannot live without a healthy ocean, as much as we cannot live without the evidences of our common history. Thank you, and I hope to see you in Lisbon.